guys, it's Isabella here, and welcome to a new video. So this video is going to be a Disney related video. We are going to be talking about all the exciting news that came out of D23 that I am excited for. So without further ado, let's get to it. So if you guys have not been able to guess what the first thing I'm going to talk about is, well, obviously it's going to be Frozen. So we got some Frozen 3 news, some positive, some very negative and very disappointing, but you know what, let's just get to it. So we got a logo, which not that huge. It's pretty much exactly like the second logo, so I have images to share with you guys. So here it is. Very colorful. Definitely not rendered really in 3D yet, but pretty much thought this was what it was gonna be based on the second Frozen's title. But yeah, we got a logo. We got concept art, but we only got one piece of concept art, and that was this image here. And I want to dissect this image a bit with you guys. So in this image, there's quite a bit happening. We have Anna and Elsa, and in the back here, we have some ominous figure. Don't know if that's going to be like a villain or some sort of, yeah, well, antagonist, villain, same thing. But this villain looks kind of ominous. Excited to see what that is. And then there's also this like castle or city. No, it looks like a castle, in the northern lights slash the clouds. The northern lights are really big in Frozen's universe. They're very magical, so maybe it has to do with that. But yeah, we don't really know any plot for this movie. Not really that much. We do know that this movie will answer the question of basically why Elsa has powers and Anna doesn't, which I guess is a good question to answer, but I don't know if we really need the answer. Maybe it is just such a good answer because they are gonna need like two movies, I think, to answer this. But anyway, next bit of news is there's a Frozen Land coming to Paris in 2026, which Paris is a lot closer to me than, what was it? Tokyo Disney, or is it Hong Kong? I don't know. Anyway, one of those countries. So obviously I couldn't go to the Frozen Lands over there, but if there's a Frozen Land in Paris and I've always wanted to go to Paris, then that's a good opportunity. So maybe one day I'll get to go to Frozen Land. Now for the sad bit of Frozen 3 news. So it was supposed to come out November 2026. They have moved it to 2027, and I think it's November of that year, and I'm so upset. I didn't want them to move it, like have it like take longer to come out. Like, come on, this is so disappointing to me. So yeah, having a bit of heartache over here. That's just some bad news, and yeah, D23 was a bummer for that. Okay, next subject with news from D23 is Zootopia 2, which is coming out very soon, and I'm so excited because I've been wanting a second Zootopia forever. And they had the like Disney Plus kind of show, but I was like, where's the second movie at? And so we got a statue, we got a logo, and we got some art. So I'm gonna share all that with you guys. So here is the logo, pretty basic, but yeah, we're going back to Zootopia. So excited. Next we have the statue, which they have new outfits, which I'm kind of digging. Look at these two! Oh my god, it's so cool. Ugh, I love these two and their partnership. It's just great. Whether they remain friends slash co-workers or whether they ever develop a romantic relationship. I just love these two and I cannot wait to see them again. Oh my god. Oh, this is gonna be so much fun. And next is the fan art, or not fan art, the official art piece that they released. So there's like, let's analyze this image. So there's a banner in the back that says Zootennial, which probably means it's Zootopia's 100th anniversary, which I like that. That's very cool. That'll be interesting. It looks like Judy and Nick are on the run. I don't know if maybe they're like, framed for something and they have to prove their innocence, which is something that's happened in cop movies before, because it looks like everyone is chasing after them. So I'm thinking that maybe like they're trying to prove, like solve a case and prove their innocence, which I think would be fun to watch. But yeah, this looks like fun. All the characters from the original seem to be back, so I'm excited. And yeah, that's it for the Zootopia stuff. Next was the announcement of Toy Story 5, which I was a bit skeptical of. I feel like we've had enough of these movies, but we got a bit of concept art and we got a description, and it sounds really interesting. So basically the toys in this film are going to be up against electronic devices like iPads and things like that, which I think is a great premise because yeah, nowadays kids have iPads. I mean, I have young cousins who still play with toys, but yeah, the iPad does kind of take some of that playtime with toys away, and I think that this is a really good concept, and I'm hoping that this movie is as good as it sounds. I liked the fourth one. I think I liked it a lot, actually, but yeah, this one seems really interesting, so I'm very excited about it. Yeah, electronical devices are a problem for children, so I can't wait to see what they do with that. For this next piece of news, I don't have anything to show, and that's third Incredibles movie. There's gonna be a third one, and I love the first one. It's definitely like grown to be one of my favorite Pixar movies, like over the, like, when I was younger, I didn't really care for it as much, but now I'm like really just, it was fun. It was really good. And I haven't watched the second one yet, but now I definitely have to, because if the third one's coming out, I have to have seen the second one. So yeah, I have to go watch that. But yeah, I'm excited. Don't know what this one's about. There was no like synopsis or story given, just an announcement. So that's gonna be cool. I also wanted to read that Twisted Tale book that's based on The Incredibles, the first movie. And yeah, I'm just on an Incredibles train right now, so. Okay, so this next bit of news, it came out of Star Wars, and this is basically the Mandalorian and Grogu movie, which I don't know if I would have preferred a movie to a season 4, but we'll have to see. So the release date that we got was May 2026, so a year and a half from now, which isn't bad. So yeah, we didn't get any news on the Rey movie, which I'm a little bummed about. I kind of wanted some news. I wanted some, like, maybe tell us what more about what it's about, but yeah, nothing about that. We also got, though, a Mandalorian and Grogu logo, so I'm going to show that to you guys. Yeah, this is it. Pretty much exact same font and everything as the TV show logo, just with Grogu in it. So, yeah, definitely excited. Got little Grogu and Mando in the title. So, yeah. Other news we didn't get any Ahsoka season 2 news. I wanted to know how that was going. I loved the first season. I watched Rebels just because of that show, and I loved it, and I love the characters. I love Sabine and Ezra, and I miss them. And yeah, The Acolyte didn't get canceled, but it didn't get renewed, or there was no season 2 announcement, so yeah, that's a bit of a bummer. But yeah, that is all for the Star Wars stuff. Okay, next is a bit of Marvel news. So there is this spin-off show from WandaVision, which is like, I think it's called Agatha All Along or something like that. They keep changing the title. Anyway, there was a trailer released, but I can't show it, obviously. But yeah, I'm excited for this show. I like witches. I like that kind of vibe. So it looks like a fun show. I'm excited for it. At first, I didn't really care. I was like, why are they doing a spinoff with this character? But the trailers have won me over. Hopefully, it's good. It's going to be releasing over the Halloween season. So excited to watch that. Next piece of news. There was a new Mufasa trailer. I'm excited for this movie. It's a prequel, which we haven't had, and it's kind of surprising me. Can't wait to watch it, and see how, like, the relationship between him and Scar, how that went all wrong, because, yeah, anyway, I'm excited to see that, that whole story unfold, and, yeah, so let's hope it's a good one. The last bit of news is, well, not that huge. There was supposed to be a Princess and the Frog series that was supposed to come out. And it was supposed to come out this year, but because of, like, delays and, like, switches in management at Disney, it's still going forward, thankfully. It didn't get canceled or anything, so I'm thankful for that. But yeah, it's been delayed, which is sad and disappointing. But it's being animated currently, so that means they're working on it, so I'm happy for that. It just won't come out this year, which I am a bit sad about, but as long as it comes out, I'm happy. Don't know why it's a Disney Plus show. Usually, Disney does these kinds of shows, like, on Disney Channel. Like, they did Tangled the series on Disney Channel, so it would be better to put it on Disney Channel, but you know what? I'm not the boss of what they do. The last thing was a little bit of a synopsis, kind of, we got. Basically, the series will feature, like, Tiana's character discovering that the world is much bigger and more magical than she, like, ever thought possible. And the series will also feature Prince Naveen's country and, like, I think it's Maldonia. And I'm excited for this. I'm like, yes, let's go to another place. Let's go see this place. Let's have all these adventures. Let's go. Let's get our characters back together. Let's have a fun time. Yes, so excited for this show. And yeah, that is all the news to come out of D23 that I am personally excited about. Let me know what you guys are excited about. What news were you guys happy to hear of? And yeah, I will see you guys in my next video, and thank you guys for 500 subscribers. I'm very thankful. Bye bye.